Welcome to Naresh AI Technologies. This is Ramchandan. In the last three videos, I did talk about related to clone concept. In the last three videos, especially I did talk about the fundamental way to learn the cloning concept and what exactly clone it is and how many types of clone we have in Java language, as well as I did introduce cloning related to shallow type. Basically, we have two types of cloning. One is shallow cloning, another one is what? Deep cloning. Already we learn about shallow cloning, and especially in this video I'm going to be talk about deep cloning. So when should we go for the deep cloning and when should we go for the shallow cloning? So if we have only primitive data types in a particular object, then only we can go for what? Shallow cloning. Otherwise we should go for what? Deeper cloning. Now here, if any object have a referenced variable, what is the problem? That referenced variable doesn't get any new memory. Both existing object as well as cloned object will reference to same referenced object. For example, if you take a student class, in the student class we have one referenced variable like ADDR, nothing but related to address object. This address object doesn't containing new memory. Then what happened? Both S1 and as well as S2, nothing but existing object and cloned object are pointing to same memory. If the existing object and cloned object pointing to the same memory, then what happened? The reason is, here the problem is, if you are doing any modification on cloned by using the cloned object on top of the address, those modifications are affected to existing object. As well as if you are doing modifications on existing object related to address, those modifications are affected to what? Cloned object. My requirement is, I want to develop a clone 100%. Nothing but even I want to develop cloning on referenced variable also, then we can go for concept like deep cloning. Now in this concept, this is this image related to shallow cloning. Here, how should we develop a deep cloning on top of this image means? Very simple. First, I want to do some cloning on the student object. Then we will get a cloned object. And we will get finally address. On top of this address, I'm going to be develop what? Clone. Nothing but, here I want to write a clone method on top of the address object, then we are achieve deep cloning concept. So for this purpose, I'm going to be develop one huge program. By using that program, I'm going to be draw again one new image to understand the deep cloning in detail. So let me start with the deep cloning program. So let me take first one class like a student. In the student class, I have variables like int SID 101 as well as string sname like what? Ram. And as well as I'm taking one object related to address. Address ADDR equal to new address. Yes. As well as here I'm taking one more class related to what? Address class. Address. In the address class, I'm taking two variables. One is city name related to like Hyderabad, and one more name like state name. Here I'm writing like Telangana. Yes. Now I'm saving this program, student.java. I'm saving this program on top of the desktop. Yes, I did. This is our student.java file. Let me take first main method, public static void main. This is what string array S. Yes. Now I'm creating an object student S1 equal to new student. Student S1 equal to new student. Whenever we creating an object like this, what happen? Observe here. First, student object is created with some data. This is student object. JVM will providing some memory. Assume that memory is 1010. Yes. Now this 1010 pointed by S1. This is S1 reference variable. S1 is pointing to 1010 memory. Yes. Now in the S1 we have some variables. One is ADDR. Initial value is what? Null. After that we have S name. Initial value again what? Null here. And one more variable like SID. That value is what? 101. That value is 101 I'm taking here. Good. Now, default initially in the non-static loading phase, all the variables will getting what? Default values. Student default value. Here default value is 0. Here default value is what? 0. And SName default value null. And address default value null itself. In the non-static initialization phase, what happened? Default values will be replaced with original value. Then 0 will be replaced with 101. 0 will be replaced with 101. Let me change color here for more identification purpose. Now null value will be replaced with name. Name like what here? Ram. And right side of the equal operator, we have one more object. We have one more object. What is that? Address object. So let me create an object for address. Let me create an object for address. This is the address object. JVM blindly provides one memory. That memory assume like what? 3030. This is the memory related to address. And this is memory related to student object. Yes. In the address object we have two variables. One is city name. What is the city name here? Default value null. And state name. What is the default value here? Null only. In the non-static loading phase we will get null values. In the non-static initialization phase, null value will be replaced with default value like original values Hyderabad. And another one is what? Telangana. Yes, these are my original object. Now, ADDR, nothing but null value will be replaced with, null value will be replaced with 3030. Null value will be replaced with 3030. What is the meaning of that? ADDR pointing to, ADDR pointing to 3030. Now, this is perfectly related to student object diagram. Now, observe here. Now, let me do the clone on top of the S1. So, in this particular time, I want to develop deep cloning. If you want to develop the deep cloning, definitely we should go for overriding the clone method. What is the syntax of the clone method here? Public student clone. Clone method throwing one exception, that is throws. Otherwise, let me show you that exception first. One checked exception throwing. Basically, clone method is the method which is existed in the object class java.lang.object class. Yes, observe here. Clone method is available. This is protected. Return type is object and throws a clone not supported exception. So here what should I do? I need to throws that clone not supported exception. Clone not supported exception. Yes. Now, if I am writing like a student, student S2 equal to S1 dot clone. Student S2 equal to S1 dot clone. Then compiler always concentrate on a reference variable type. What is the reference variable type here? a student. So control is going and checking in the student class. Is there any clone method? Yes, this method is going to be executed. But I don't know what exactly logic for doing the cloning. Still, I am going to be depend upon what superclass cloning. What is the superclass clone? What is the superclass for student object class? If any object wants to participate in the cloning, that object must and should be implements what? Clonable interface. Already we learned this point in the previous videos. And here, address also must and should be implements what? Clonable. Now, super dot clone. If I am calling like a super dot clone means, control go to super class clone method. So, what is the super class for student? Java dot lang dot object class. So, with the help of the java.lang.object class clone method logic, we are going to be develop for your cloning. Now, here I am taking student, it is giving a return type like a student object, but it is not if giving in the format of student, it will giving in the format of a super class type like object. Then what should I do? I need to convert it into student type, nothing but downcasting. Super.clone is providing information in the format of object. java.lang.object format, I want to change into what student type, then we should go for downcasting. Now after that, what should I do? If I am writing like s1.clone, one new object is created. New object is created with new memory. This is my new object. Now, observe guys, this ADDR. And this is what S name and this is SID. Now, whatever the data which we have in the S1, all the data will coming to what here? One more variable here for more clarity purpose, I am changing S1 into what? S3. Now, JVM will providing new memory. Now, memory like what? 4040. Otherwise, let me take here 2020. That memory pointed by what? S2, or here I am taking what? S3. S3 pointing to 2020. Now this is what exactly. Now SID value. What is the SID value? Whatever the value which we have in the S1, that SID value will come here. And here what? S name like what? Ram here. Now what is the ADDR value? ADDR value is also what here? Initially 3030. Now observe guys. Now what I am doing here is, this dot, this means current reference. What is the current reference here? S1. S1 dot ADDR. Nothing but S1 dot address. S1 dot ADDR is nothing but S1 dot ADDR is nothing but S1 means 1010, dot means ADDR means 3030. Now I am applying cloning on top of this object, nothing but address object. Now ADDR dot clone. Now here I am doing what here? Cloning. So here simply I am writing like dot clone method. Whenever we doing the dot clone method, one new object given by the one new object given by the JVM. Yes. Here the data is city name. What is the city name here? City name like Hyderabad and state name like Telangana. This is my data. So JVM blindly provides what? One new memory. Assume that memory is what? 4040. That is the memory. This one I am placed into what? This dot ADDR clone means we will get one new memory, that is what? 4040. This 4040 I am placed into initially ADDR pointing to what? 3030. Now if I am writing like this dot ADDR dot clone, JVM will provide the new object for address. So for this purpose I am taking one override method public. What I am getting? Address I am getting here. And what is the method name? Clone. And it is throwing what? Exception like clone not supported exception. Yes. Now here is also I don't have any cloning logic. Then what should I do? Return address of super dot clone. Again, I'm depend upon object class clone method. Here address is also subclass of what? Java dot lang dot object. Java dot lang dot object. Finally, this statement will giving one new object like 4040. That 4040 I am placed into where? S3 dot ADDR. Now what happen? 3030 will be replaced with new memory. That is what? 4040. Now the old connection is going to be break. Like 3030 connection is going to be break. Now ADDR pointing to new memory. That is what? 4040. Now in this particular time, these four objects, individual objects, these two having some connections and these two having some connection. If you go for the shallow connection, what happen? Both existing object and cloned object pointing to same memory. But in this particular time, what happen? I'm creating one new cloned object on top of the address. Whatever the address we are getting, a new cloned object related address, that address I'm placed into where? S3 dot ADDR. And finally, it is going to be written what? S3. Nothing but this S1 dot clone will be replaced with S3. That will be placed into where? S2. Nothing but we have some other reference variable. That is what here? S2. That is S2. S2 pointing to 2020. Now S3 is what? Local variable. Whenever control is come out of the clone method, automatically local variables are going to be destroyed. Nothing but here this reference is going to be deleted, but memory is not deleted. Why? If any memory having external reference variable, that memory is comes under what? Used memory. Garbage collector never clean the used memory, only unused memory by default. If you want to clean the used memory, then what should we do? As a programmer, mention what? Null value into that particular reference variable, then only referenced object or used memory is going to be cleaned by the garbage collector. But by defaultly, garbage collector always concentrate on unused memory itself. Now let me show the output related to these two particular objects, system.out.println s1.sid. This information belongs to s1, and just copy and paste all these data. Control V, and the one is Control V. Now this is what S name, this is what s1.addr.ctname, and this one is s1.addr.stateName. This is what exactly our content. Now again same thing I'm going to be copy paste for S2. Control C, Control V. Yes, this is exactly S2 type. S2, all are belongs to S2 only. This is S2. Yes, this is the S2. Now let me compile and execute this program right now. So Java C student dot Java. Yes, very good. Now here small spelling mistake, like java dot lang. After that, yes, s3 dot addr, cannot find a symbol. s3 dot addr. Now what I'm doing here is, I'm writing like this dot ADDR. After that, S3 dot ADDR equal to ADDR. Okay. Now, observe here. One more. What type of variable? Yes, I'm taking only ADD, not hardier. So this is the ADDR. Now anyhow, everything is fine here. Instead of writing like this, directly I'm writing S3. Yes, unreported exception, clone not supported exception. Here my clone method throwing what? One checked exception, that is throws clone not supported exception, and after that again I'm compiling the program. Yes, successfully compile. After that what I'm getting? Finally I'm getting the output like observe here. Whatever the data which we have in the S1, whatever the data which we have in the S1, entire data will coming to where here? S2. Now observe guys, here small difference. In the previous shallow cloning concept, if you are doing any modifications on top of the clone, remaining objects are going to be disturbed. But in this time what happened? Observe, I'm going to be changed somewhat content related to S2. How I'm changing? Observe, S2 dot ADDR dot city name equal to Vizag. Now again S2 dot ADDR dot state name, here I'm writing like what? Andhra Pradesh. This is my content. Now again I'm going to be copy and paste the data related to S1, S as well as related to S2 itself. Yes, I'm saving. Now observe here, clear the screen. Again I'm going to be executing this program. Yeah, S1, I'm doing modification on top of the S2. What is that? Telangana will be replaced with Andhra Pradesh, and Hyderabad will be replaced with Vizag. But those modifications are not affected to what here? S1. That means by seeing the diagram we can easily grasp the internals of deep cloning. Here 1010 and 3030 are part of the, are entirely comes under one part, as well as S3, and S3 is nothing but 2020 and 4040 comes under entirely one part. So if you are doing any modification on top of these two objects, those modifications never be affected to these two. This type of cloning we can call as what? Deep cloning. The main advantage of the deep cloning is each and every variable, maybe it is belongs to the primitive variable, maybe it is belongs to what? Referenced variable. Every variable gets what? New memory. That is the part of deep cloning. If you go for this shallow cloning, what happen? Only primitive variables will getting the new memories, but reference variables will getting what? Common memories. So this is the part of the cloning. Now let me give conclusion to a deep cloning. Whenever we writing S1 dot clone method, internally JVM will provides one object. Internally JVM will provide one object in the format of super class. Here I told you like we are overriding the clone method in our student class. Basically, if you watch object class clone method, java.lang.object class clone method, the clone method return type is what? Object type. Clone method return type is what? Object type. But here I mention what? Student. So if you want to override the any method in Java language, we need to follow some rule. What is that? Subclass method access modifier must and should be same or increasable. So here access modifier is protected. So we did increasing accessibility modifier like public, and return type must and should be same. What is the return type here? Object. But here I mention what? Student. One of the future of Java 1.5, that is what? Covariant return types. Covariant return types means in the subclass method return type may be same as superclass method return type, or we can write it's a subclasses. Student is the subclass of object. So before the clone method we can write return type as an object as well as what here? Student. But it is only valid from Java 1.5 onwards. So up to now I completed all the types of object creation. Mainly, we have 5 types of object creations. One is the new, another one is clone, deserialization, factory methods, as well as what? Literals. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more videos, please subscribe Naresh IT channel. Thank you.